Konstanz. Ja, Konstanz. War das sollte die Welt konstant? Konstant. Now, when we talk of constant, we are basically referring to a number. A number now does not change. For example, how many eyes have you? Yes, you have two eyes, and it doesn't change. So that is a constant. In mathematics, we have a lot of constants, but we have different forms of the constants, and that's what we're going to go through today. Oh, yes. We have one, we have two, and then we have three. I'm going to use these ones to illustrate the forms of constant I would like to take you through today. Now, with the introduction of n, I'm referring to any number. So any number can be 1, 2, 3, 50, 87, 100. Yes, any number is a constant. And that is what you should take note of. We have another form of constant I'd like to take you through. This you see here is called pi. Yes, pi. And there is a numerical value of pi. That makes it a constant. What is the numerical value of pi? Yes, the numerical value of pi is 22 out of 7. And you can write this 22 out of 7 as 3.142. Yes, you can use the long division to find out. So pi is 22 out of 7 or 3.142. And it is a constant. Okay, now look at this. We have a right angle. And this is how we write a right angle. Right angle is also a constant. Why? Because whenever we talk of a right angle, we are referring to 90 degrees. Yeah, so this is also a constant. Beautiful. What about a circle? Yes, the total angle of a circle is 360 degrees. So it tells us here that 360 degrees is also a constant. Yes, now let us move on to the other form of constant that we have. I began the very first one with a small c. The c you see here refers to the speed of light. So c is a constant. And the numerical value of C is 3.0 to the base 10 raised to the power 8 meters per second. This is also a constant. We have another constant called G. Yes, this is acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration due to gravity. And it also has a numerical value by approximation to be 10 meters per second squared. We also have the big G. Yeah, we also have the big G. And what is the big G? The big G happens to be 6.67 to the base 10 raised to the power negative 11 newton meter squared per kilogram squared. Yes, so this is also a constant, and the G here is called Newton's universal gravitational constant. Yes. And you have a whole lot of constants you can consider. For example, what is the mass of the Earth? Yes, the mass of the Earth, we represent by ME, happens to be 6.0 raised to the power 6.0 to base 10 raised to the power 24 kilograms. And then what is the mass of the sun? The mass of the sun happens to be 2.0 to base 10 raised to the power 30 kilograms. Yes. Okay, now there are little things I would like you to consider. When you look at the very first form of the constant, nothing was attached. Yet they are constant. But when you look at the other one, you realize that this one was in the form of a ratio. It is also a constant. Well, you can write it in terms of decimals. It is still a constant. Now, when you look at this, you realize that you have attached a unit. And the unit you're talking about here is the degrees. Yet, they are constant. And then, when you look at the other one, I mean, the third form of the constants we have, they have been attached by their respective units. And you see, they are just different. Yet, they are constant because the numbers we have do not change. So, a constant is simply a number. As to whether you attach a unit to the number or not, a constant is just a number. This is where I'll bring this lesson to its successful end. Thank you.